So speaking of that, you actually, you guys, she's got a great blog out there. We can link to it in the web, in the video, but you did something about, I think it was like Fruit Loops and what was it called?
Fruit Loops and Kool-Aid.
Yeah, it spoke to me because obviously as a dietitian, like I'm huge into real food and huge into like teaching others that it doesn't have to be a diet, but it needs to be a lifestyle.
Right.
Tell us a little bit about what your real food lifestyle looks like. Maybe not a whole day, but like what it means to you.
Sure. For me, it just means buying as much whole, fresh food as I can. So things that are not packaged, things that are not in, you know, processed and packaged. So just meats, produce, you know, the old staying around the perimeter of the grocery store. Very little dairy. And then just making sure I'm cooking that food and getting it cycled through so I don't have, like, old things sitting in my kitchen.
Yeah.
That's something that's been sort of a process to learn how to do that. Like, I used to buy a lot of fresh food and then some would go bad because I didn't kind of quite know how to gauge the right amount. And I wouldn't have enough, you know, recipes in place to be able to use the stuff up. So gotten better at that over time. And just really trying to use it as our lifestyle and also to educate my son about nutrition. So if there's a treat that's like he sees it advertised, you know, and he says, well, why can't we eat that? And I'll explain, well, we can eat that, but here's why we don't eat that very often.
Right.
So it's kind of just an ongoing process.
Yeah. And you got a little guy at home. He's 8, you said?
Yeah.
Yeah. And so how do you feel? I mean, I feel like you're working against the media all the time. So as a mom, and this is kind of something you were talking about in the blog post, how do you ensure that, you know, he's looking up to you?
Right. Well, you know, I do think it is about role modeling. So you can tell them things all day, but if you're not doing it, then it's just not going to stick. And I really look at all of it as a teaching opportunity for him. So every time we see advertisements, and it's not just food, it's kind of our culture, our consumer culture as a whole, that I sort of want him not to be indoctrinated with that, even though it's kind of, we're bathed in it all the time.
Yeah.
So it's always a learning opportunity. So why do they have Spider-Man on this bag of apples or this bag of chips or this Ninja Turtle, like, tortilla chips?
Right.
Like, why is that?
You it's kind of crazy and sad that the kids don't know better.
It is sad because it's kind of taking advantage. And I know it's like a multi-million dollar industry to know how these kids' brains work.
It is.
You know what I mean? Yeah. And so as parents, I think it's huge for us daily to kind of talk to our kids about that. Well, that's marketing. You know, see a McDonald's commercial. Like, oh, this is for kids. Well, it's really not for kids because this is what's actually in it, you know?
Exactly. Well, I'm glad you're such a good role model. He's got a good mom. Not many people are doing that. So why don't you tell us what maybe your favorite post-WOD meal is? Because a lot of people always ask that. They want to know, what do you eat post-WOD?
Usually it involves a sweet potato, which is kind of common. So I'll either bake it and just eat it plain, or maybe have a little bit of cinnamon, maybe some coconut oil in there mixed in, like just mash it up. And then typically green vegetables, so either kale or broccoli.
You're like a woman after my own heart, right?
Yeah. And then a meat. So it's usually going to be chicken or like a ground turkey.
Yeah.
I just have like my little Tupperwares and laid out neatly.
Plan ahead, people. I think that's one of the questions I always get is I need a protein supplement. And I think for maybe the top athletes to get to that point, sure.
Right.
But most people, I mean, do exactly what, that's awesome. I love hearing that.
Yeah.
So then speaking on another term, what would be your favorite, if you had to treat yourself with food, what would be your favorite treat? Your most decadent dessert or snack or maybe it's meat.
I haven't been doing a lot of treats lately, so nothing's popping out, but, one of my favorite desserts is like cheesecake. That would be more of a special thing. I try to, if I'm going to have a dessert, I want it to be like something special.
Yeah,
so not just like something I can just grab, like whatever. But
she's human.
Yeah, of course. A more everyday, like if I have a sweet tooth, maybe like an apple and almond butter. That really does for me satisfy that little craving for sweetness and enough to that I don't really want any other junk food most of the time. But yeah, I do like cheesecake, chocolate cake, cupcakes, all that stuff is good.
Oh, good. I'm glad you're human.
Yeah, of course.
But it's finding that balance. And I think it's good that you said the thing about apple and almond butter because you're just finding a different way to enjoy a sweet that's not going to basically ruin your entire lifestyle.
It's amazing how that works. And I think, you know, how your palate sort of changes if you reduce the amount of kind of sugar you're putting in. You don't really want it anymore.
Right.
And so if I'm on a roll, I just kind of stay on that roll and have maybe like a dried fruit or something like that that's a little sweet to meet that need or that taste, that taste desire. So
that's awesome. I'm glad to hear. I'm a real foodie, so
yeah.
I'm right on the same page. So finally, the last kind of area I want to touch on. I think you wrote something, maybe them thighs or something.
Oh, right. Yeah.
And I love that. I mean, we're always trying to promote like good body image, especially for women, because men come in here and they lift 500 pounds and it's like, they're amazing.
Right.
The second us women do it, it's almost like, oh my gosh, like your man friendly, you're right. this, you're that. So what message do you have to tell women about their body image?
You know, I mean, I always try to promote just love of wherever you are and whoever you are. So you'll see, like, on social media, I post just a lot of, I will post pictures of myself because I think it's an image of fitness that's not what you're going to see on a magazine. Mm-hmm. I've never been a petite person, and so kind of embracing that and showing other women that it's cool to be all yeah. different shapes and sizes. But I think in the bottom line is kind of embracing yourself and not letting external factors influence that.
Yeah, awesome. Well, that's all I got. So thank you so much for joining us here.
Thank you.
We're at CrossFit Evita in Albany, New York. Once again, I'm Laura, the Sassy Dietitian with Elizabeth Akinwale, CrossFit Games athlete. We're excited to see how you do in regionals, and she's going to be doing a seminar here. So that's it.